Hello, harmonica enthusiast. I'm going to be sight reading a piece of music for you today. I have not played my harmonica yet today. The instrument is cold. Now, I would like to say that I'm sight reading this piece of music cold, but I have been staring at it for about 7 minutes and kind of doing an analysis of it before I attempt to play it. This really is a test. I can't go back and redo this video if I mess up. I did have a teacher that said, when you're sight reading, just keep going. I'm not going to do that. If I mess up, I'm going to just start from the place or a couple measures before I messed up and play it again. If I need to, I will isolate a passage and rehearse it. And that itself could be educational, because if you're a musician that can read music and you're looking at a new piece, it's good to identify the weak places. And my music teacher used to have me in pencil draw a parentheses around the fragments, the places in the music where I was struggling. And then he just had me loop that. Just play those three or four measures over and over. So you're rehearsing the weak point until it's stronger. Then you go back to the top, play the whole piece. You get to that part that you were struggling, and you're not struggling anymore. And then anyway, so I'm going to talk maybe a little bit about my process if I'm looking at a piece of music for the first time. I may just flat out grab an instrument and start playing it. However, I do want to pay attention to things like the time signature and the key signature. So this song is in three, and I see one flat. Now, I know the song's in D minor already, because let me just back up a page. This, you can find this, is flutetunes.com. They have a song a day. I have kind of forgot about this. But what a great resource to, if you're learning to read music or kind of an intermediate reader like I am, a song a day, and they're not too hard. Like, this piece of music is not appearing to be very difficult. This is September 5th. We're not doing my former wife. I'm sorry. That just came out wrong. But happy Labor Day from America. But we're going to do Sunday's song, yesterday's song, Study in D Minor by Garibaldi. This is a guy, it says he's an Italian romantic flutist and composer, Giuseppe Garibaldi. And the level of difficulty is easy. So, okay. Anyway, going to the next tab where I have the song. This key signature of one flat is typically F major. The relative minor key is D minor. So I know it's in D minor. I have practiced the F major scale quite a bit, and its relative minor scale, the D natural minor scale, quite a bit. And as I'm looking at the music, I'm seeing that for the most part, the notes are moving in this scale tones. They're not skipping around too much. And then when we get to a certain point where we start seeing C sharps, I would say the fact that I have practiced the not just the D minor, D natural minor scale, but the D harmonic minor scale, that's getting me ready. A lot of classical pieces, you're going to see a lot of C sharps in this key of D minor. So let's see. The other thing that I'm seeing is like measure 21, 2, 3, 4, 25. I see A major arpeggios happening in 25 and measure 27. So to kind of warm up my harmonica, because it is cold, I'm going to play the F major scale, maybe over two octaves.
Thank you.
And then I'll play the relative minor scale. I'll run those A major arpeggios. I have to think about the C sharp. I am going to play the second C sharp because there's two in a row, but that'll get me ready for that. Now, I just posted a video called 10 Reasons Why You Should Practice the Major Scale. One of the reasons was that it will help you with sight reading. And so this song should be a piece of cake. I don't know if it's going to be a perfect piece of cake when I first read it. Did I mention I'm gonna stop if I need to? Did I say that? Anyway, I'm going to stop if I need to and rehearse passages or just come in again partway through. I'm not going to like go back to the beginning if I don't need to. The thing that I see at the end is a D minor arpeggio, the last three measures. So that's maybe I'm cheating. I rehearsed the last three measures in advance, but that's just an arpeggio. I always have to think, where's the skip in the D minor arpeggio? It should be easy. They're all draw notes, you know. There's no slide involved. But you have that note skip, particularly when you play these arpeggios over a two-octave range like that. Anyway, you're going to note the tempo marking. It says poco allegretto, which is an Italian word for fairly brisk, I think. It's supposed to be a brisk tempo. I have my old Franz metronome here, and I have it set on 108, and we're just going to hear 2 3 1 2 3. I'm not going to play with the metronome. I'm going to keep the tempo loose if I need to stretch a phrase out, just to kind of give myself some grace. But I'm seeing 1 2 3, and I can now can I hear the music when I'm just reading it in my head? Sometimes. I'm not going to attempt to sing pitches, but I'm going to sing rhythms. 1, 2, 3, ba da 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 da, ba da 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 da, ba da 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 da, da 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 da, da 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 da, 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 da da. Do-do-do-dee-da, do-do-do-dee-da. So repeating the first theme. And I'm seeing this pattern of we're climbing up the scale. The next measure, we start one scale tone lower, and we're playing the same shape, the same exact shape, but down a scale degree. And that happens four times. Then I'm seeing the same shape phrase, except this time we're starting on an A. This is in measure 9. And so I'm kind of getting a feel for these phrases before I attempt to play them. So instead of four times, it goes six measures of that shape of phrase. Skipping over to measure 17, we have rhythmically the same figure, only the phrase is not exactly the same shape. It's a descending figure. And there, each measure, it goes down a scale tone and then descends down the scale, four more notes. And that, there's four measures of that. And then we get into some A arpeggios. I'm going to just attempt this. So one more time, but the tempo, 1, 2. How do I feel? Do I have butterflies? No. Let me get my first note. See how I do. I got the tempo in my head. So, can I just stop and play those first measures again? Maybe a little slower. So that was correct and not exactly in time. So, I don't know, that was a B minus. Let's think about where I wasn't entirely smooth. I'm going to take it from 21 maybe and just rehearse the next four bars. One more time. Okay. That was better. Again, not awesome. Measure 28. Anyway, that's me looking at a piece of music and reading it and playing it. And if I spent some time with this, I could really start to, for one example of drilling down a little deeper and making this more musical is the fact that there are dynamic markings, which I completely ignored, which is fairly typical if I'm sight reading. Like, to me, the notes and rhythms are most important, but I could have, if I even paused before I played, you know, I looked at some specific things that talked about arpeggios and scale tones and so forth. If I would have looked at the dynamic markings, I would have been more prepared. So really the first 14, 15, 16, the first 16 measures. No, that's not right. The first 14 measures are supposed to be pianissimo, which is soft. And then we have like measure 15 is supposed to be loud. That's a forte. And then over here, measure 16 is supposed to be mezzo forte, which is like a medium loud. And then we go back to forte. So I really was just putting air through the harmonica, trying to play notes and rhythms. Am I going to go back right now? No. Maybe on my own time. But yeah, I could have played the beginning softer, and I just forgot to even look at that. Let me talk about where I got this. I've been to flutetones.com before. I can't remember the original place that I found it, but a couple years ago, I was reading this blog post by John Kipp. If you've never been to John Kipp, .com, please go there. It's inspiring. And John Kipp is kind of a humorist. The way he writes is funny. And And he's a guy who was a professional woodwind player in Los Angeles studios, made friends with Tommy Morgan, retired from being a woodwind player in the studios and really focused on chromatic harmonica. And there's some recordings or links to YouTube things where you can hear him play. I was impressed enough with the website and his playing that I actually did like a whole, I did a blog post on my website just to try to point people to his website because I think it's cool. And this article is how to practice. And with his typical humor, he gets into this, talks about getting a flute book and learning how to read while going through the flute book. Stay tuned. I plan on going through some kind of music book and teaching how to read the harmonica. But when you run out of that book, here's what it says here. He sends us to this place called flutetones.com, which has a new song every day. And I'm imagining you could just keep going back in time to previous posts. And I love that they have the difficulties. Here's one by the same composer, study in F major. I'd like to, from the same book, 58 First Exercises, I'd like to come back and look at that one. Should I try to read that one? Stop. No, go away. Okay, and then I click on PDF sheet music. That's what I do. I'm not going to attempt to play this. I do play flute, and I could play this on the flute, but this has too many leaps. I mean, I'm going to have to, no, I'm not going to do it.